Thank you. Absolute truth as being Abhijna and Swarat. 在第一个世界之中 ，Vyasadeva 定义绝对真理是 Adigyana和 Svanat。
Adigyana meaning all cognizant, he knows everything.
Adigyana 的意思是全知的，他了解所有的一切。
So to know everything, usually we depend on somebody to tell us about everything.
为了了解一切，一般我们需要依靠其他的人告诉我们关于所有的一切。
Right, whatever we know, we learn from somebody else.
无论我们知道的什么，都是从其他的人那里了解到的。
But Lord Krishna knows everything on his own. He's not dependent on anybody else.
但是主 Krishna 他自己就知道所有的一切，他并不依靠任何其他的人。
So he's not just Adigyana. He's not just all-knowing, but he is also independent.
因此他并不仅仅是 Adigyana， 他并不仅仅是全知的，他还是完全独立的。
Only Lord Krishna is all-knowing and independent.
只有主 Krishna 他是全知的，而且是完全独立的。
Lord Krishna is also described as Janma Jashya, that he is the cause of the creation, maintenance, and dissolution of the manifestation.
主 Krishna 还被定义为是 Janma Jashya， 也就是说他是物质的宇宙的展示的原因、维系还有毁灭。
So Srimad Bhagavatam begins in the same way as the Vedanta Sutra.Vedanta Sutra also begins Janma Jashya.
Srimad Bhagavatam 的开篇跟 Vedanta Sutra 是一样的， Vedanta Sutra 的开篇也是 Janma Jashya.
So this shows us, this tells us that Srimad Bhagavatam is a commentary on the Vedanta Sutra.
这就向我们表明 Srimad Bhagavatam 是 Vedanta Sutra 的评论。
Sometimes the other Sampradayas.They have their own acharyas. Each of their acharyas wrote a commentary on Srimad Bhagavatam.
Sometimes
we find that another Sampradaya was challenging that the Gaudiya Vaishnavas is not a bona fide Sampradaya.
曾经一度，其他的 Sampradaya 挑战我们的 Gaudiya Vaishnava， 说我们不是一个正宗的 Sampradaya。
And they said that if it was a bona fide Sampradaya, it should have its own commentary on Vedanta Sutra.
他们说，如果你要是声称自己是一个真正的 Sampradaya 的话，必须要有自己对于 Vedanta Sutra 的评论。
Shankaracharya had a commentary on Vedanta Sutra. Ramanuja wrote a commentary on Vedanta Sutra. Nambarka has a commentary on Vedanta Sutra.
香卡尔查耶有对于维丹特苏哲的评论，拉曼努贾阿查耶有对于维丹特苏哲的评论，宁巴尔卡阿查耶也有对于维丹特苏哲的评论。
So they were challenging, where is the Gaudiya Vaishnava commentary on Vedanta Sutra?
他们在挑战 Gaudiya Vaishnava， 他们对于维丹特苏哲的评论在何方
？And the devotees of the Gaudiya Vaishnava said, "Not sure if the answer they brought the commentary on Vedanta Sutra."
Gaudiya Vaishnava 们就说 Srila Vyasadeva 对于维丹特苏哲撰写了评论。
Srila Vyasadeva is the author of the Vedas, and he is the knower of the Vedas, and he wrote the Vedanta Sutra, and then he commented on it in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Srila Vyasadeva 他是维达经典的作者，他撰写了维丹特苏哲，而且他以 Srimad Bhagavatam 的形式对维丹特苏哲进行了评论。
But these people who were challenging the authority or the authenticity of the Gaudiya Vaishnava, they said, no, this is not. This is Srila Vyasadeva's own commentary. Your Sampradaya should have your own commentary.
然而这些挑战者他们就说 Gaudiya Vaishnava 的这些奉献者们说 Srimad Bhagavatam 这个不算， Vyasadeva 写的不算，你们应该是有自己对于 Vedanta Sutra 的评论。
And so it was Baladeva Pinchabhusan who actually wrote that commentary.
于是巴拉德维德布闪便撰写了对维丹特苏哲的评论。
There's a place near to Jaipur where he went to do his bhajan, and that place he wrote the Vedanta Sutra, the commentary.
在斋普附近有一个地方，巴拉德维德布闪去那里撰写了关于维丹特苏哲的评论。
So Srila Prabhupada very much appreciated that commentary, and he dedicated his Bhagavad Gita to the commentary of Baladeva Pinchabhusan.
Srila Prabhupada 非常欣赏那一部评论，所以他把自己的 Bhagavad Gita 献给了巴勒提卢维迭波山的那种评论。
That commentary is called Govinda Bhashya, the speaking of Govinda.
那部评论的名字叫做 Govinda Bhashya, 也就是 Govinda 的讲述。
Baladeva Vijayapurasan had gone to Jaipur to meet the challenge from the Ramananda Sampradaya who were claiming we were not an authentic Sampradaya.
巴勒德维杰布山他去了斋普，他去迎接拉曼杜加他们的这些派系桑普达雅的挑战，因为他们说我们不是一个授权的一个桑普达雅。
These Ramananda people had influenced the king of Jaipur, and they told the king of Jaipur the Gaudiya Vaishnavas are not an authentic Sampradaya.
这些 Ramananda 们他们告诉了斋普的国王说高迭巴什纳瓦们不是一个正宗的桑普达雅。
Now the king of Jaipur.Was actually a supporter of Gaudiya Vaishnava, and he had given Govinda, he brought the Govinda deity had been brought to his palace for safety.
Jaipur 的国王他也不倾向于Gaudiya Vaishnava们，而且他把 Govinda 的神像带到了自己的宫殿里，以保证他的安全。
But these Ramanandi people were telling the king that this is not a bona fide sampradaya. You shouldn't follow them.
这些 Ramanandi 们他们就告诉斋普的国王说你不应该去听那些高迭巴什纳瓦们的，因为他们不是一个正宗的桑普达雅，不是一个正宗的师父传系。
So this brought the news came to Vrindavan that somebody has to come and defend the position of Gaudiya Vaishnava.
消息传到了 Vrindavan, 大家说应该有一个人来为高迭巴什纳瓦主义的地位进行辩护。
But Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur was in poor health at that time, so he sent his student, Baladeva Vijayapurasan.
当时 Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur 健康非常的不佳，于是他派出了自己的学生 Baladeva Vijayapurasan.
And Baladeva Vijayapurasan went there, and he was given the challenge, you have to write the commentary. If this is really a Sampradaya, then write a commentary on Vedanta Sutra.
巴勒迪维迭布山接受了这个挑战，人家说如果你们真的是一个正宗的桑普达雅，你应该写出一部对于维丹特苏彻的真正的评论来。他做到了，他写出了一部评论。
And he called it the Govinda Bhashya.
他管这个叫做 Govinda Bhashya.
Because he prayed to the deity of Govinda Ji before trying to write.
因为他在写作之前向 Govinda Ji 的神像祈祷。
Before we try to accept any service on behalf of the Lord, we must always seek the blessings of the Lord.
当我们代表主在接受一项任务的时候，我们必须要寻求主的祝福。
You can see in the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the first canto, Sutta Goswami was questioned by the sages of Naimisharanya.
大家可以看到，在《须曼巴格坦》第一篇之中，苏格德鲁格斯苏特格斯瓦米受到南玉舍尔眼森林之中圣人们的质询。
So Sutta Goswami, after being questioned, he offered his prayers to his spiritual master, Sukadeva Goswami.
当苏特格斯瓦米受到这些圣人们的询问之后，他便向他的灵性导师苏格德鲁格斯瓦米献祷文。
Sukadeva Goswami was his spiritual master because Sutta Goswami had heard Sukadeva Goswami speaking the Bhagavatam to Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 是他的灵性导师，是因为当时 Sutta Goswami 是听到 Sukadeva Goswami 向 Maharaj Parikshit 讲述了 Srimad Bhagavatam.
And then he also prayed to not of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Lord Narayan.
他接着向至尊人格守神拿大眼的祈祷
and to the supermost human beings Narayan Narayan Rishi
向超人拿大拿大眼的力气祈祷
and to Mother Saraswati the goddess of learning
向学问女神 Saraswati 母亲祈祷
and unto Srila Vyasadeva the author
而且向作者 Srila Vyasadeva 祈祷
So very important before we attend anything we must first of all offer our prayers and seek the blessings.
所以这是非常重要的。当我们在做任何事情之前，我们应该先献上祷文，求得祝福。
You can see in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna does Kaviraj. Before writing Chaitanya Charitamrita, he first of all went to the deity of Madan Mohan.
你们可以看到，在《Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita》之中 ，Krishna does Kaviraj Goswami.他在撰写《Chaitanya Charitamrita》之前，先向 Madan Mohan 的神像祈祷。
And then he went to the deities of Radha Govinda.
然后他去见 Radha Govinda 的神像。
And Radha Gopinath.
然后去见 Radha Gopinath 的神像。
And he got the blessings that he could write about the pastimes of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
接着他得到了祝福，可以撰写主差团的马哈布布的逍遥时光。
So in every endeavor, we must seek the blessings. Srila Prabhupada, before he went to America, he took blessings.
在每一次努力之前，我们都需要取得祝福。Srila Prabhupada在他去西方之前，他首先求了祝福。
He went to places like Shantipur.
他去了像山地图这样的地方。
Which is.The home of Advaita Acharya.
那里是 Advaita Acharya 的家。
And he sought blessings to go to the west.
他寻求祝福可以去西方。
Sukadeva Goswami was asked to speak on the process of creation.
Sukadeva Goswami 被要求讲述一下创造的程序。
Sukadeva Goswami also offered very deep prayers seeking.Blessings from the superior authorities.
舒克德有个苏阿米那里，他也献上了很深刻的祝福，很深刻的祈祷，祈求至尊者的祝福。
Sukadeva Goswami was a liberated soul from birth, but still he thought he took the blessings from his superior.
舒克德有个苏阿米从出生起就是一个已经解脱了的灵魂，但是仍然呢，他要从他自己的长辈那里求得祝福。
Superiors like Srila Vyasadevi and Narada Muni Lord Brahma.
他的长辈好比 Srila Vyasadevi, Narada Muni, 主 Brahma.
So we all need to understand how much we're dependent on the blessings of the superiors.
我们所有的人都应该明白到我们在多大程度上要依靠我们的长辈的祝福。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna tells Arjuna.Nimitta Matra Bhava Sakya Sanchin Become an instrument in my service.
在包括地铁之中 Krishna 告诉儿中呢说在我的服务之中成为一个工具。
Nimitta Matra means become an instrument.
Nimitta Matra 的意思就是成为一个工具。
Even if you're Savyasachi, Savyasachi means one who is very expert in his fighting ability.
即使你是 Savyasachi,三位杀气的意思是在作战的过程之中是非常专业的。
Arjuna was expert archer. We know what he did to win the hand of Draupadi.
Arjuna 是一位专业的弓箭手，我们知道为了赢得 Draupadi 的手，他做了什么。
They had the archery contest, and you had to pierce the eye of the fish.
大家举行了一场射箭大会，必须要射穿一只鱼的眼睛。
But the fish.Was up in the ceiling, and there was a wheel rotating in front of the fish.
但是这个鱼被吊在天花板上，而且在鱼的前面挡着一个不停转动的轮子。
And Arjuna was not allowed to look directly up; he had to look at the reflection on the water.
而且 Arjuna 不允许直接的往上看，他只能够看底下的这个水上的倒影。
So it was really a difficult challenge which he had to face.
因此他所面临的真正的是一个很大的挑战。
But Arjuna is expert and he pierced the eye of the fish.
但是 Arjuna 是非常的专业的，他最后射穿了鱼的眼睛。
Arjuna was also able to use both hands. He was both left-handed and right-handed. He was ambidextrous.
Arjuna 可以同时用两只手，他既可以用左手也可以用右手，相当于双手并用。
And Arjuna could fire arrows in the dark.
而且 Arjuna 可以在黑暗之中射箭。
So he was so expert, but still, he is simply an instrument in the service of Krishna.
他是如此的专业，但是仍然在 Krishna 的服务之中，他仍然是一个工具。
Krishna told Arjuna that I'm making the arrangements. You just become an instrument in my service.
Krishna 告诉儿子呢说是我做了所有的安排，你仅仅是在我的手中成为一个工具。
Just like Rupa Goswami became an instrument in the service of Lord Chaitanya.
就像 Rupa Goswami 成为朱柴坦尼的一个工具，就是服务的工具。
He was empowered to write scriptures on the pastimes of Lord Krishna.
他被授权撰写关于主 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
Just as the Vedic knowledge was imparted into the heart of Brahma, the beginning of the creation.
就像是在创造的一开始，伟达的知识被传授给主布拉玛的内心。
The Vedic knowledge was imparted into the heart of Brahma. Tenhe Brahma Ridai Adi Kavaye. It's not that Brahma himself composed the Vedic knowledge, but it was put into his heart by Lord, the Supreme Personality of God.
伟达的知识被传授到布拉玛的内心之中，不是说他自己去获得这个知识，而是说由至尊人格守神把知识输入到他的内心之中。
So in the same way, Rupa Goswami was empowered to write scriptures about Lord Krishna.
同样道理，如果格斯瓦米受到了赋予被赋予了力量，授权去撰写关于经典，关于 Krishna 逍遥时光的经典。
Where all the devotees are all instruments in the service of Krishna.
奉献者们在 Krishna 的服务之中都是工具。
And Prabhupada also said about his books. He said, I have not written these books.
巴布巴还提到了他的书，他说这些书都不是我写的。
Sometimes.Especially in Los Angeles, Prabhupada would sit in his garden, and someone would come and sit and read Krishna book to him.
曾经有一次，舍勒帕帕坐在洛杉矶的一个花园里，然后有人在给他读 Krishna 至尊人格守神这本书。
And Prabhupada would take pleasure in hearing the pastimes of Lord Krishna from his own book.
巴布巴非常高兴，从他自己写的书中去聆听 Krishna 的逍遥时光。
And when Prabhupada heard.The stories read, he would say, "I have not written these books."
当帕布巴听到这些书被读出来的时候呢，他说这些书不是我写的。
He said, "It's been written by Krishna. Krishna's written it through me."
他说这个是 Krishna 写的，是 Krishna 通过我写的。
So we also have to become instruments in the service of Krishna.
因此，我们也应该成为对 Krishna 的服务的工具。
In whatever service we're doing.It may be cooking, it may be cleaning, it may be chanting.
无论我们做什么样的服务，可能是空调，可能是做就是清扫，可能是念诵。
There's so many wonderful ways we can try to serve Krishna.
有很多奇妙的方式，我们都可以去服务 Krishna.
The other day, we went to the Vyasa Puja of His Holiness Bhakti Raghava Swami.
前几天我们去参加 Bhakti Raghava Swami 的 Vyasa Puja.
Bhakti Raghava Swami is a sannyasi who has crutches, on crutches. He has only one leg.
Bhakti Raghava Swami, 他是一位拄拐的 Swami, 他只有一条腿。
He lost a leg when the temple was attacked.
当庙宇被攻击的时候，他失去了一条腿。
It was about 1984.
大概其实1984年。
Some dacoits came in and they wanted to steal the deities from the altar.
有一些歹徒来试图从神坛上偷走神像。
Because they understood the deities were gold.
因为他们认为神像是金子做的。
So they come with guns.
于是他们带着枪来。
And they came in and I don't know if they got the deities or not. I can't remember. I was in Calcutta at the time. I was not.
我不知道他们是不是把神像偷走了。当时我不在马尔普罗，当时我在加尔各答。
But they came in, and Bhakti Raghava, he got a bit involved, and he got trying to stop them, and they threw a bomb, but the bomb blew off his leg.
他们闯进来之后 ，Bhakti Raghava 试图阻止他们，于是他们扔了炸弹，而这个炸弹就把Bhakti Raghava Maharaj 的一条腿给炸黑了。
So that's how he lost his leg.
这是他如何失去了自己的腿。
Trying to defend the deities from these dacoits.
努力的想要保护神像免于歹徒的侵犯。
So he was a very brave young man.
他是一个非常勇敢的年轻人。
Usually the dacoits come, people come with guns and stuff. You just want to keep away, keep back.
通常如果要是有歹徒来还带着枪，你只想赶快的躲到后面去。
But Bhakti Raghava, at this time he was a brahmachari, he was not a sannyasi, he was a brahmachari.
但是 Bhakti Raghava 当时他不是 sannyasi, 他是一个 brahmachari.
He was very bold and he challenged the dacoits.
他非常的勇敢，他挑战了那些歹徒。
And the result was he lost his leg.
结果是他失去了自己的一条腿。
But this has not stopped his preaching.
但这并没有阻止他的传播。
He continues to be very, very active.
他继续非常非常的活跃。
And you can read there was a Back to Godhead article written about him.
大家可以读一下，在《挥挥手神》杂志上专门有一篇关于他的文章。
And the article was called "The Lame Can Cross Mountains."
这篇文章的名字叫做瘸子可以翻山越岭。
Maybe you know this verse: "Mukam karoti bachalam pangam langai tigirin yatripa tamaham bande Sri Guru Dinatarinam Paramananda Madhavan."She changed and not Ishwaram, right? Jayapadakamaraj often chants it.
您可能都知道这个诗节，加帕达克马哈经常唱诵这个诗节。
By the mercy of the spiritual master, a lame man can cross mountains.
通过离心导师的仁慈，一个瘸子可以翻山越岭。
A blind man can see the stars.
一个瞎子可以数满天星斗。
A dumb man can recite poetry.
一个哑巴可以朗诵诗歌。
So.The first part says, "Pangam langai tigirin." The lame man can cross mountains.
第一部分是 "Pangam langai tigirin," 也就是一个瘸子可以翻山越岭。
So this is a very nice way of describing Bhaktiraghava Maharaj. He was involved in the pioneering the Namhata preaching.
这是一种非常好的描述，可以适用在 Bhaktiraghava Swami 身上，因为他是 Namahata 传播的先驱。
He would go out into the villages and go and visit the villages and get people to chant Hare Krishna.
他去一个村庄接着一个村庄，让人们唱诵 Hare Krishna.
And we can see the results today, how we have so many Namahata centers all over Bengal.
我们可以看到这个结果。如今呢，在整个的孟加拉有这么多的 Namahata 的中心。
And then he went to South India. He did the same there in South India.
接着他去了南印度，他在南印度做了同样的事情。
In South India, people are not Gaudiya Vaishnavas. They don't have the culture like the Bengali people. It's different.
在南印度，人们并不是高迪瓦什纳瓦，他们跟孟加拉的人的传统是不一样的。
South Indian people are more into worship of demigods.
南印度的人更喜欢崇拜半神人。
And they never heard of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
而且他们从来没有听说过 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So it was quite bold to go there to preach Krishna consciousness.
所以去那个地方传播 Krishna 知觉是非常需要勇气的。
But Bhakti Raghava.Went there and he helped to establish the Namahata preaching there.
但是 Bhaktiraghava Swami 去了那里，并且确立了 Namahata 的传播在那里。
And today there are many, many Bhakti Brikshas there. There are many, many devotees there.
而如今呢，在那里有很多很多的 Bhakti Briksha， 也有很多很多的奉献者。
So, another achievement of Bhaktiraghava is that he's very much involved in developing the Vanashram Institute.
Bhaktiraghava Swami 他的另外一项成就是非常成功的树立了 Varnashram 的机构。
And he says Srila Prabhupada desired that everywhere there should be Varnashram colleges.
他说 Srila Prabhupada 曾经说过，所有的地方都应该有 Varnashram 的大学。
It means we have to train people according to their nature that they can be properly engaged.
意思是说，人们应该按照他们的本性得到训练，这样他们可以有恰当的从事。
Not everyone is a brahmana.
不是每一个人都是 brahmana.
Not everyone can worship the deity and study scriptures.
不是每一个人都可以崇拜神像并且学习经典。
You know, some people by nature they like to be more administrators and managers.
我们知道有的人他们的天性就更适合去当一些管理者，还有行政的管理者。
Other people are more into business.
其他的人更倾向于做生意。
Or maybe agriculture, farming, taking care of the cows.
或者是喜欢农耕去照顾乳牛。
And other people just like to work. They should be told what to do.
还有一些人喜欢工作，他们是喜欢去劳动，应该被告知应该做什么。
So everyone has to be properly engaged according to their nature.
所以 按照自己的本性不恰当的从事。
Nowadays, the nature of everyone, they only think how to get money.
如今每一个人的本性都变成了怎么才能挣钱。
They just want to become wealthy to have sense gratification.
大家都想变得非常富有，从而有更多的感官享乐。
They think I will live comfortably.
他们想着我要生活得非常舒适。
They simply serve their own senses.
他们仅仅是在服务自己的感官。
And they never inquire about the absolute truth.
他们从来不去询问绝对真理。
The real goal of life is to inquire about the absolute truth.
而人生的真正的目的是去询问绝对真理。
At least that's the beginning of human life.
至少这是人类生活的开始。
When we start to ask, who am I? Why am I here?
当我们应该去询问我到底是谁？为什么我在这里？
So people are not educated properly.
人们没有得到恰当的教育。
We think, oh, I go to this school, get good education.
大家想着我们去上学可以得到很好的教育。
Yes, good education in how to serve the senses.
是的，这个好的教育指的是如何去服务感官。
We don't get any real spiritual education.
我们并不能够得到真正的任何真正的灵性的教育。
Simply we learn how to satisfy the senses.
我们仅仅去学习如何去满足感官。
So Krishna conscious education is very much required today.
所以 Krishna 知觉的教育如今是非常迫切需要的。
We need to guide people how to make proper use of the human mind.
我们应该恰当的去指导大家如何去好好利用人体生命。
Just how to read books like Srimad Bhagavatam.
如何去阅读像施曼巴格坦这样的书籍？
People are all educated how to use their mobile phone.
人们现在接受的教育都是怎么去用手机。
Every night you can go outside our Mayapur Institute, just outside on the gateway on the road there, and you see a number of young Bengali boys sitting there, and each one has a mobile phone.
就在马普学院的这个大门口外，每天晚上，如果你出去的话，就看到有成群的孟加拉的年轻的小伙子们都在玩手机。
And they're all sitting watching the different movies.
他们都坐在那看着不同的电影。
And they're thinking this is success in life.
他们觉得这就是人生的成功。
They're thinking this is happiness.
他们认为这就是快乐。
This is how to pass the life.
这就是怎么去度日。
We will watch the movie, or we will watch the football or the cricket game on the mobile phone.
我们在手机上看电影，看足球比赛，看板球比赛。
And in this way, we will enjoy. We will live forever and be happy.
这样我们就会享受，我们会一直活下去，一直快乐。
Nobody is thinking that one day we have to leave the world.
没有一个人想到，终于有一天我会离开这个世界。
Everyone's got a bit of remote, just like Hirani Kashipu.
每一个人都有一点儿 Hirani Kashipu 的那种情绪。
Just like Hirani Kashipu thought, I will never die.
就像是 Hirani Kashipu 想的一样，我永远不会死。
But Lord Nrisimhadev came, and in a few moments he was dead.
但主女性的队友来了，在片刻之后他就死了。
A cruel death comes, even though we try to avoid it.
即使我们试图去避免，但是残酷的死亡仍然会到来。
We have to understand what is the nature of this material world.
我们必须要明白到这个物质世界的本性是什么。
Jiva Goswami explains, we should not over endeavor to acquire wealth.
基瓦索斯瓦米解释说，我们不应该过分努力地去追求财富。
We should simply have enough to maintain our life.
我们只需要有足够的能够维系我们生活的东西就可以了。
And then use our time to inquire about the absolute truth.
然后把我们的时间用在探寻绝对真理上。
Of course, material world people are only thinking how to get more wealth.
当然，在物质世界之内，人们总是想着如何得到更多的财富。
They have more than enough to live.
他们的生活已经远远超过自己所需。
But they're still thinking how to get more.
但他们仍然在想着如何得到更多。
So Krishna comes in the form of time.
于是 Krishna 以时间的形式到来。
Just to take everything away.
就是为了把所有的一切都拿走。
And we're seeing. We're seeing what's happening in the world today.
而且我们可以看到，看到在这个世界上如今发生着什么。
Building big cities.
摩天大楼，很大的城市。
And people are all locked in their apartments and cannot come out.
人们都被封锁在自己的公寓之中，不能够出门。
In China, they say every time they come out, someone will stick something in their nose and just check them to see if they've got COVID.
据说在中国，每当有人出门的时候，就会有人把一个东西贴在你的鼻子上，然后检查一下，看看你是不是得了新冠。
Every day, every moment they're coming.
每一天，每时每刻，他们都来检查。
Just to check. Nobody, people get to the point nobody wants to know. Better not to come out. Just stay at home.
就是为了检查，所以人们达到了这种程度，大家都不愿意动弹了，不愿意出去，就待在家里。
So the world is becoming this kind of condition.
世界已经变成了这种地步。
Even though you have vaccinations, it's not protecting you.
即使有疫苗，也是无济于事，这并不能够保护你。
People say, "Oh, if you're not vaccinated, you'll die."
人们说，如果你不去打疫苗，你就会死掉。
Everybody gets vaccinated, everybody still dies.
但是人们都打了疫苗，可是人们还在死去。你无法去阻止死亡。
We live by the grace of Krishna and we die by the grace of Krishna.
我们通过 Krishna 的恩慈去生活，我们通过 Krishna 的恩慈去死亡。
We just have to surrender to Krishna.
我们只需要去臣服于 Krishna.
Our life is in His hands.
我们的生命在他的手中。
He is the controller. We're not the controller.
他是控制者，我们不是控制者。
What can we control?
我们能控制什么呢？
Just to control the bowels is hard.
仅仅控制我们不拉肚子就够难的了。
Material your body so much trouble.
物质的躯体有这么多的麻烦。
So Lord Krishna is teaching us, this world is not meant for enjoyment.
所以主 Krishna 在教导我们，这个世界是不是为了享受的
？But it is meant for atato brahmajnana.To inquire about the absolute truth.
这个世界的目的是 atato brahma jigyasa, 是为了探寻绝对真理。
And for that purpose, great sages came and they wrote wonderful scriptures.
为了这个目的，伟大的圣人们他们降临，为我们撰写了奇妙的文献。
We have to take advantage to study these scriptures.
我们必须要好好的利用研习这些经典。
We see, Great devotees like the Goswamis, how they lived in Vrindavan.
我们可以看到那些伟大的奉献者，比如说 Goswami 们如何在 Vrindavan 生活。
They were very wealthy men, but they gave up everything to come and live in Vrindavan.
他们本来是非常富有的人，但是他们放弃了所有的一切，来到 Vrindavan 生活。
To live under a different tree every night.
每一天晚上住在一棵不同的树下。
And to live just simply.By begging whatever they could get from whatever was given to them by the grace of the inhabitants of Vrindavan.
他们的生活仅仅是靠乞讨来维系，就是看Vrindavan的居民们能够给出多少仁慈。
They didn't worry about their needs, about their bodily demands.
他们并不担心自己的需求，自己的身体的所求。
They were so absorbed in thinking of Krishna, Krishna consciousness.
他们非常的沉浸在 Krishna 知觉之中，想着 Krishna。
And we can see how they can do wonderful things.
我们可以看到他们如何能够做到非常奇妙的事情。
Building temples like Madan Mohan and Radha Govinda.
建筑庙宇，比如说 Madan Mohan, Radha Govinda.
Beautiful, huge temples, magnificent temples.
很美丽、很庞大、很宏伟的神庙。
Although they went there with nothing, they were able to.
尽管他们去那儿的时候一无所有，但是他们却可以达成所有的一切。而且他们发展了 Radha Kun, Shama Kun, 非常美丽的 Gods。所有的这一切都是通过 Krishna 的恩慈被赐予他们的。
Krishna gives for the devotees.
Krishna 会给奉献者提供一切的。
Because when the devotee sincerely desires to serve Krishna, Krishna provides.
因为当一个奉献者非常诚恳的想要去服务 Krishna 的时候， Krishna 就会提供。
So we are all endeavoring for our service to Krishna.
我们全都在非常努力地去服务 Krishna。
We want to try to render some kind of small service.
我们想做一些微不足道的服务。
Chanting the holy name.
唱诵圣名。
Here in Mayapur, very nice place to chant the holy name.
在马尔普这里是一个很好的唱诵圣名的地方。
We must develop our taste for chanting here in Mayapur.
我们必须在马尔普这里发展我们唱诵圣名的品味。
We should develop our taste to hear and discuss the scriptures.
我们必须要发展我们去聆听和讨论经典的品味。
Srila Prabhupada wanted very much that we would know Prabhupada's books.
舍勒帕帕非常想让我们去了解舍勒帕帕德的书籍。
So very good, nice to see the devotees studying the books together.
看到奉献者们一起学习书籍，这是非常令人高兴的一件事情。
This you have to go on, you have to continue to do this.
这个是大家必须要继续的，必须要一直的进行下去。
Nobody should give up.
没有人应该放弃。
Don't say, oh, it's too much. Oh, I'm too busy.
不要说哦，这简直是太过分了，我太忙了。
It's the most important activity of the devotee.
这是奉献者最重要的活动。
Jiva Goswami says the most important type of devotional service is hearing and chanting the glories of Krishna.
Jiva Goswami 说。最重要的奉献服务的活动就是聆听和唱诵 Krishna 的荣耀。
So we're so fortunate we have these wonderful books, we have this treasure.
我们非常的幸运，我们有这些奇妙的书籍，这是一笔很美妙的财富。
Every devotee should know the contents of these books.
每一个奉献者都应该了解这些书籍的内容。
One devotee now he's also translating the whole Ramayana.
现在有一个奉献者在翻译整部的 Ramayana.
The original Ramayana, Valmiki.
是原本的 Valmiki 的 Ramayana.
We have some versions which devotees have taken, published English editions of Ramayana, which they've taken from other people.Edited them, put them into better language. But it's not complete.
我们有一些其他的关于 Ramayana 的版本，一些奉献者他们从其他的地方找到这个版本，然后进行编辑。不过这个版本，这些版本都不是完整的。
But this one devotee is a disciple of Jagatthakur Swami Maharaj. His name is Vidwan Gauranga, and he's a very learned devotee. He knows Sanskrit very well.And he's translating the Ramayana, Valmiki Ramayana.
而有这样的一个非常优秀的奉献者，他是圣佛加达他的 Swami Maharaj 的门徒，他非常的有学识，他的名字叫 Vidwan Gauranga 师傅，他在翻译 Valmiki 的原本的 Ramayana.
So he already translated the first three cantos of the Ramayana.
他已经翻译好了 Ramayana 的前三篇。
And there are 24,000 verses.
一共有两万四千个诗节。
24,000 verses. Each verse, each 1,000 verses begins with one syllable of the Gayatri Mantra.
这两万四千个诗节之中呢，每一千个诗节都会以 Gayatri Mantra 的一个音节开始。
Brahma Gayatri Mantra has 24 syllables.
Brahma Gayatri Mantra 有二十四个音节。
So he's begun each 1,000 verses. He's begun with one of the 24 syllables.
所以他每写一千个诗节，就会以这二十四个音节之中的一个为开始。
Gayatri Mantra is the meditation on the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Gayatri Mantra 是对至尊人格守神的冥想。
And we are also by reading books like Ramayana and Srimad Bhagavatam, we are also meditating on the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
通过阅读像《Ramayana》还有《Srimad Bhagavatam》这样的书籍，我们也在冥想至尊人格守神。
In Srimad Bhagavatam, in the very first verse, Srila Vyasadeva has written, "Satyam Param Dimahi."
在《Srimad Bhagavatam》的第一个诗节之中，Srila Vyasadeva他写到 "Satyam Param Dimahi."
Satyam Param means supreme truth.
Satyam Param 的意思是至高无上的真理。
And Dimahi is from Gayatri Mantra.
Dimahi 来自于 Gayatri Mantra.
It means I meditate.
这个意思是说我冥想。
We meditate on the absolute truth.
我们去冥想绝对真理。
Who is Lord Sri Krishna?
他是主 Sri Krishna.
And similarly, Ramayana is a meditation on the supreme personality of Godhead, Lord Rama.
同样道理 ，Ramayana 是对至尊人格首神主 Rama 的冥想。
So some people worship Lord Rama, some people worship Lord Krishna.
有的人他崇拜 Rama, 有的人崇拜 Krishna.
Of course, Lord Krishna is the Supreme Lord. Lord Rama is coming from Krishna.
当然了，主 Krishna 是至尊主，主 Rama 来自于主 Krishna.
Murari Gupta was a great devotee of Lord Rama.
Murari Gupta 是主 Rama 的一位非常献身的奉献者。
Lord Chaitanya was telling him.Just worship Radha and Krishna. Why worship Sita and Ram?
主觉三年告诉他说，只是崇拜 Radha Krishna 吧，为什么要崇拜 Sita Rama?
So Murari Gupta came the next day and told Lord Chaitanya, "I will have to give up my life."
Murari Gupta 第二天告诉主 Chaitanya 说，我必须要放弃自己的生命。
You have told me to give up the worship of Sita and Rama, and I cannot do it.
告诉我要放弃对希特拉曼的崇拜，但是我做不到。
I cannot follow your order. You've given me instruction, but I cannot follow it.
我无法遵从你的命令，你给了我训令，但是我却无法遵守。
I should give up my life.
我应该放弃自己的生命。
But Lord Chaitanya said, "No, that's okay."
但是主宰太太说不，没关系。
You are Hanuman.
你是哈努曼。
Hanuman could never give up the worship of Sita and Rama.
哈努曼永远不可能放弃对西达和 Ram 的崇拜。
Even though he knows that that Lord Narayana and Lakshmi are the supreme personality of Godhead, Radha and Krishna, and he knows they're greater than Sita and Rama, but Hanuman said, "I can never give up the worship of Lord Rama."
尽管他知道 Narayana 和 Lakshmi 他是属于至尊人格守神的这个范畴，但是。他无法放，他知道，Radha Krishna 更加的高超，但他无法放弃对 Sita Ram 的崇拜，是因为他是哈努曼。
So Lord Chaitanya appreciated very much that mood of faith and chaste devotion to the Supreme Lord.
主觉三界非常欣赏他对于至尊主的这种坚定的信念，还有崇拜的贞洁。
Sometimes people are not very faithful, not very chaste. They can go here, they can go there.They can worship this one. They can worship that one.
有的时候人们不够有信心，不够贞洁。他们有时候去这个地方，有时候去那个地方，就崇拜这个，有时候崇拜那个。
But Murari Gupta was fixed. He wanted to worship Sita and Rama.
但是 Murari Gupta 是非常坚定的，他就想崇拜 Sita 和 Rama.
And Lord Chaitanya very much appreciated this deep faith.
主觉三昧非常欣赏他的这种深深的信心。
We also have to develop that kind of faith, to be very fixed and faithful in our worship of the Lord.
我们也应该发展出这样的信心来。我们在我们对主的崇拜之中，应该非常的有信心。
We want to follow Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
我们想去追随主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
You know, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the incarnation of the Lord, the Kali Yuga avatar.
谢谢他的马哈普鲁是主的化身，他是卡利尤嘎阿瓦塔尔。
And he has come to deliver all of us.
他的到来是为了拯救我们所有的人。
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya glorifies Lord Chaitanya with a beautiful phrase: "Vairagya vidya nija bhakti yoga shikshata eka purusha purana Sri Krishna Chaitanya sharera dari."
萨婆婆摩巴达查耶用无上这个师节去荣耀主宰他们呀。
He said, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has appeared in the age of Kali in the notion of mercy.
他说，主宰他们马哈普鲁显现在卡利年代，他是仁慈之羊。
And he's come to teach us vairagya, detachment from everything which does not foster Krishna consciousness.
他到来教导我们 Vairagya 就是不依附于所有不利于我们进行 Krishna 知觉的事情。
Along with transcendental knowledge, Vidya.
他还连同他教导我们，还有连同超然的知识 Vidya.
And wherever there is devotion for the Supreme Lord, then there will naturally be Vairagya and Vidya.
只要有对于主的这种超然的服务，那么就一定会有 Vairagya 还有 Vidya 的存在。
In the Srimad Bhagavatam first chapter, the sages ask six questions to Sutta Goswami.
在《Srimad Bhagavatam》的第一篇第一章之中，那个时间的森林之中的圣人们问了 Sutta Goswami 六个问题。
The first question was, what is the ultimate good for all the people? The ultimate good, Shreya. The word is Shreya, meaning the ultimate good.
他们问的第一个问题是：对于所有的人而言，最终极的好处是什么 ？Shreya， 他们使用的词是 Shreya， 最终极的好处是什么
？There is Shreya and there is Priya。
有 Shreya， 还有 Priya。
Priya means material good。
Priya 的意思是物质的好处。
What is immediately good for your sense gratification？
也就是对于你的感官满足立刻有好处的东西。
And what is for your ultimate good？
还有对你最终极有好处的东西。
So Sutta Goswami wants to know what is the ultimate good for the people.
因此 ，Sutta Goswami 他就是这些圣人们问他，到底为了所有的人而言，最终极的好处是什么
？So Sutta Goswami answered, "Sabaipum sam paro dharmo yato bhakti rahoksaje ahaitaki apratiyata yayatma supersedati."
Sutta Goswami 回答如上。
The supreme occupation for all humanity to attain is loving service to the Supreme Lord.
所有的人类应该达到的最高的职责是对于至尊主的奉献服务。
The highest occupation, the best occupation for everyone anywhere is service to the Supreme Lord.
最高的职责在所有的地方，对于每个人而言，最好的职责就是对至尊主的服务。
I was teaching a unit of Bhakti Bhai Bhav yesterday afternoon. We had a group of people from different countries.
昨天下午我在给大家讲 Bhakti Bhai Bhav 的一个单元，然后同学们来自于各个不同的国家。
So we had an interesting exercise.
我们做了一个非常有意思的练习。
We gave them an interest. We told them that there's a young man who is the son of a very wealthy life member.
我们告诉大家说，有一个年轻人，他是一个非常富有的人家里的成员。
And he's studying medicine.
他在学习医学。
And he's really a good student.
而且他是一个特别好的朋友，这个学生。
He's in the top 3%.
他是全班的3%顶级。
And he's already in the fourth year.
而且已经是第四年了。
But he happened to reach Srimad Bhagavatam.
结果他刚刚得到了 Srimad Bhagavatam.
And he came across the statement in Srimad Bhagavatam that duties executed by all men are only useless labor if they do not provoke attraction for the Supreme Lord.
他读到 Srimad Bhagavatam 之中有一个师节说到，如果要是一个人履行普通人的职责，这种职责不让人对至尊主产生任何吸引之心的话，那种职责就是没有用处的。
Guru Mukha knows very well. She's a Bhakti Bhai Bhav graduate.
Guru Mukha 知道的非常清楚，他是 Bhakti Bhai Bhav 的毕业生。
A very good student.
非常好的一个学生。
So, Sutta Goswami said, the highest, the real occupation is the devotional service.
因此 ，Sutta Goswami 说，最高级的职责就是奉献服务。
So yesterday we were asking the students, you know, the young boy.The young man is studying medicine. His father is very rich, and he's thinking that why should I study this medicine? It's useless. I'm not developing a taste for hearing and chanting.
昨天我们就问所有的同学们，这里有一个年轻人，他是一个医学的学生，而且他的家庭非常的富有。那么他现在学习医学有什么用处呢？他就想着最好我还是去念诵吧。
And he's thinking of giving up his medical studies.
于是他想着要放弃自己的医学的学习。
And his father's a rich man and he's supporting the temple.
而他的父亲是一个富人，在支持庙宇。
What are you going to do?
你们怎么办呢？
And they, all the, most of the students were all saying, "Oh, tell him to go back and study."
绝大多数人都说，哦，告诉他回去学习吧。
They were all saying, oh, he should just stay in the studies, just let him finish his, he can always be a doctor, he can give money to the temple.
然后大家都说让他回去吧，让他继续学业，然后可以成为一个医生，他总可以把自己赚的钱给庙里。
And if he's a doctor, he can still preach.
如果他是一个医生的话，他仍然可以 可以去传播。
No. Wrong.
错了。
How stupid.
你全都是太愚蠢了。
Because you're all congregation, you're not full-time devotees, you think he shouldn't become a full-time devotee.
因为你们全都是这种会众的成员，你们并不是全职的，所以你们就觉得他也不应该成为全职的奉献者。
And so many people can be doctors.
我说有这么多的人，他都可以当医生。
We're not short of doctors.
我们并不缺医生。
We're short of preachers.
我们缺乏的是传播者。
We need people to dedicate their life for the service of Krishna.
我们需要有人能够献出自己的一生去服务 Krishna。
Think going to be a doctor is that going to be the mode of goodness, Joe?
你觉得成为医生就可以去做善良属性之内的工作吗？
Cutting up people's bodies is the mode of goodness?
你觉得去切割别人的躯体是处在善良属性之中吗？
Being in a hospital with all the young nurses and all the sick people, and you think that's the mode of goodness?
待在医院里，整天跟年轻的护士以及病人们在一起，你们认为这就是？在善良属性之中吗？在那里有很多的激情。
Better become a dedicated devotee.
最好还是成为一个献身的奉献者。
So the mass of people are in ignorance, they're thinking, "Oh no, I want my child to be a doctor."
绝大多数人他们都会处在愚昧属激情属性之中，都想着哦，我想让我的孩子成为一个医生。
No, no.Just give your child to me. Let him come with me.
不不不，把你的孩子给我吧，让他跟我在一起。
We'll train him up to be a nice devotee.
我要把他训练成一个很好的奉献者。
No, 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 no. That'll be, he's going to be a doctor.
让他去当医生吧。
This is the ignorance of the material world.
这就是物质世界的愚昧。
People don't know what is the real goal of life.
人们并不知道生命的真正目的是什么。
Even they're supposed to be devotees.
甚至他们也应该是奉献者。
And they're studying Bhakti Vaibhava.
他们在学习 Bhakti Vaibhava.
And they're thinking, no, let my son be a doctor.
他们还是在想着，哦，让我的儿子成为一个医生吧。
Oh, don't let him shave his head.
哦，不要让他剃头。
Don't let him.
不要让他成为一个奉献者。
He can be a part-time devotee.
他可以成为一个就兼职奉献者。
Material world, so much delusion.
物质世界里充满了幻象。
We're trying to break that dream, get people out of that dream of the illusion of this material world.
我们想打破大多数人的梦，我们想打破大家对这个物质世界的幻想的梦幻。
Because we're always thinking the world is becoming nicer.
我们一直在想着这个世界变得越来越好了。
Oh, we're getting nicer.Better cars.
Oh, 我们得到更好的车。
Nicer clothes.
更好的衣服。
Oh, nicer jewelry.
更好的珠宝。
Oh, more makeup to put on our face.
更多的化妆品可以涂在我们的脸上。
We're becoming more and more perfect in our life here.
我们在这个地方的生活变得越来越完美了。
So it's just a dream. It will never be successful.
这只是梦想而已，永远也不会成功的。
This world is doomed to failure.
这个世界注定会是失败的。
Doesn't matter who is in charge of the government.
无论谁掌管政府。
Doesn't matter what party is in power.
无论是哪个政党当权。
None of them will ever be successful.
没有一方会成为成功的。
The goal of life is to develop love for Krishna.
生命的目标是为了发展对科士纳的爱。
So we should be convinced.
所以我们应该信服。
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
谢谢方爱，谢谢翻译。那个什么问题来着？忘了。我有很多问题啊，一说就忘了，不知道哪个问题。
还
问一个，那个我们经常去那个恒抛发的嘎，去那个有个恒河的女神的庙，我们国家法源说百川之最是恒河，就是河流中最厉害最伟大的恒河，在瓦特里说， 所以我看崇拜恒河，我的想法就是我们怎么看这个恒河，把它当母亲，把它当奉献者，还是把它当成伴随者，我们跟它的关系是什么。
What is our relationship with Ganga?
Yeah, what is our relationship? We can see Ganga as a mother, or we can see as a demigod, or we can see as a
devotee.
In Srimad Bhagavatam, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Lord Chaitanya told one devotee, he said, you worship Lord Jagannath, who is the Lord in wood, and you worship Mother Ganga. He said, the Lord comes in the form of wood and in the form of water. In wood he comes as Lord Jagannath, and in water he comes as Mother Ganga.
在《修习丹的查尔塔姆特》之中，修习丹的马哈波布告诉一个奉献者要崇拜主加格纳。他说主加格在这个年代主以两种形式降临，以木头的形式还有水的形式。木头的形式就是主加格纳特的形式，水的形式就是刚格恒河的形式。
We see there were great devotees of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who were also great devotees of Mother Ganga, like Kolavika Sridhar and Pundarika Vidyanidhi.
我们可以看到，就全他的马哈瀑布的伟大奉献者，他们同时也是刚的，就是恒河母亲的伟大奉献者。比如说 Kolavika Sridhar， 还有 Pundarika Vidyanidhi。
Pundarika Vidyanidhi, he was very unhappy to see people bathing in the Ganga with soap.He would simply come to the Ganga and he would offer obeisances to Ganga. Some Ramanuja Vaishnavas generally, they won't bathe in the Ganga, they will just offer obeisances to Ganga.
有些 Ramanuja 的 Vaishnava 们，他们是不会在恒河之中沐浴的，他们只是到恒河边上顶拜。
And Kolavika Sridhar used to spend half of his income every day to worship Mother Ganga.
Kolavika Sridhar 他会每天把自己挣的钱的一半用来崇拜恒河。
So what should be our attitude towards Mother Ganga?
我们对于恒河母亲的态度应该是什么呢？
I asked Jaipataka Swami about Mother Ganga one time. We were talking about what should be the mood. And he said, well, just like we approach Mother Tulsi, we approach Tulsi Maharani, a great devotee, to get her blessings to go to Krishna.
有一次我曾经问过加帕达克马哈尔是关于对于恒河的态度，然后他就说，就像是我们对待 Tulsi 母亲的态度。Tulsi Maharani 她是一个纯粹的奉献者，我们应该得到她的祝福，然后再到 Krishna 那里去。
Right, we pray to Tulsi when we do Tulsi Puja. I beg you to make me a follower of the coward damsels of Braja. Please give me the privilege of devotional service. Make me your own maid servant.
我们在做 Tulsi 的崇拜的时候，我们会向 Tulsi 祈祷。请让我成为弗拉加的这些少女牧牛女们的一个仆人，请让我能够在那里能够服务 Krishna。
So we can also pray to Mother Ganges in this way also, that please help me on my path back to Krishna。
我们也可以这样向恒河母亲祈祷，请帮助我在我回归 Krishna 的路上对我进行协助。
We know that the water of the Ganga is coming from it's washing the lotus feet of Lord Vamanadeva。
我们知道恒河水是来自于濯洗瓦曼纳德夫，主瓦曼纳德夫的这个足的这个水。
It's the water of the Kashi Ocean.
这是来自于元婴之洋的水。
So it's very very special potency.
因此是有非常非常特殊的力量。
But at the same time, we're also told that the Ganges purifies after a long time.
但是同时呢，我们也被告知恒河是要在使用很长时间之后才能够净化一个人。
But the pure devotees can purify immediately.
但是纯粹奉献者可以立刻净化一个人。
So we do want to get the blessings of Mother Ganga. We want to help, pray that she will help us in the path back to God.
我们的确是想得到恒河母亲的仁慈，我们向她祈祷，让她能够协助我们在回归守神的道路上。
The earth is also mother.
地球也是一位母亲。
You worship Mother Ganga as mother, you can worship the earth also as mother.
我们崇拜恒河，她是一位母亲，我们也可以崇拜大地，大地也是一位母亲。
Cow is also mother.
乳牛也是母亲。
Actually, Ganga is not one of the mothers.
其实 恒河并不是七位母亲之一。
But still we could think of them because she's the rivers are always feminine.
但是我们仍然可以这样想，是因为所有的河流都是阴性的。
So with respect, that's the main thing.
所以要恭恭敬敬的，这才是最主要的方面。
那他们给恒河女神供奉着和撒旦，我们是不是也可以荣耀？他们每天都给恒河女神供奉着，我们可不可以荣耀？应该。
我们可以荣耀给恒河母亲供奉的给撒旦。
Yeah, we think Prasadam offered to great devotees.
是的，我们可以荣耀给伟大的奉献者们供奉过的菩萨的。
If it's like Vyasa Puja, we offer the Prasad, you know, take the Prasadam. So something offered to Mother Ganga, we can also accept, yes.
就像是 Vyasa Puja 的时候，我们给一心导师供奉之后，我们可以荣耀菩萨的。我们给恒河母亲供奉的这个菩萨的，我们也可以接受。
Hare Krishna Maharaj, I have a question. You mentioned at the very beginning that the blessings are very much required for service, for example, open teaching centers. So I just would like if you could elaborate more onto the details of how to get those blessings.
这位马正吉的问题就是说，马哈是在讲课的一开始提到，我们在每一次努力之前都应该去祈求祝福。他可能想去开一个传播的中心，说想马哈是能不能够详尽的解释一下如何得到祝福。
Well, we can get the blessings by offering prayers. That's one way.
那么有一种方式就是我们可以通过祈祷来得到祝福。
You want to get the blessings. The blessings should be for something spiritual. However, it shouldn't be for anything material.
你想得到祝福，这个祝福应该是灵性的，这个祝福不应该是为了任何物质的东西。
You want to get blessings, the blessings should be for our advancement in Krishna consciousness.
你想得到祝福，这个祝福应该是为了帮助我们在 Krishna 知觉之中取得进步。
So simply offering prayers and offering obeisances and in this way, that certainly we can attract the blessings of these great personalities.
我们供奉祷文，供奉顶拜，这样一定可以吸引那些伟大人物对我们的祝福。
Prabhupada told us, you want to get the blessings of Radha and Krishna, you want to enter into the pastimes of Radha and Krishna, you have to first of all get the mercy of Lord Nityananda.
Prabhupada 说，如果你想要得到 Radha Krishna 的仁慈，你想进入 Radha Krishna 的逍遥时光，首先你应该得到主 Nityananda 的。
How to get the mercy of Lord Nityananda? You have to take up his mission, the mission of Lord Nityananda.
你如何能够得到主尼天丹丹的仁慈呢？你必须要承担起主尼天丹丹的使命。
Lord Nityananda went to deliver the Jagai and Madhai.
主尼天丹丹去拯救加盖和马太。
So you want the blessings of Lord Nityananda? You have to help in that mission to deliver the Jagai and Madhai people.
如果你要是想得到主尼天丹丹的仁慈，你就必须要参与到这种拯救加盖和妈代这样的人的使命之中。
And when Lord Nityananda is pleased with you, then he will bring you to Lord Chaitanya.
当主尼天丹丹对你满意的时候，他会带你去见主 Chaitanya.
And Lord Chaitanya can introduce you to Radha and Krishna.
而主 Chaitanya 可以介绍你给 Radha 和 Krishna.
So you have to understand what is the mission.Of these great people, you are seeking their blessings. You have to take up their mission.
所以你应该好好的考虑一下这些伟大人物的使命都是什么。你想得到他们的祝福，那你就要承担起他们的使命。
When we study Bhakti Shastri and Bhakti Bhai Bhav and so on, one of the headings which we also look in Srila Prabhupada's books, we think about Prabhupada's mood and mission.
当我们在学习 Bhakti Shastri 还有 Bhakti Vai Baba 的时候，我们在书里经常会遇到的一个标题就是说施乐帕帕德的情感和使命。
So Prabhupada's mission to deliver Krishna consciousness, to educate people about the mission of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
施乐帕帕德的使命就是要传播 Krishna 知觉，然后让所有的人都得到主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的仁慈。
And if even one person can become a devotee, then Prabhupada would consider the mission as successful.
哪怕是一个人成为奉献者，释迦牟尼也会认为他的使命成功了。
So Prabhupada wanted to see that we were dedicated to this mission.
释迦牟尼想看我们到底有多么献身去参与这个使命。
Distribute books, Prabhupada taught us.
Prabhupada 教导我们要派发书籍。
Go everywhere.
去所有的地方。
Try and get everyone to chant the holy name of Krishna.
努力的让每一个人都唱诵 Krishna 的圣名。
Fulfill the prediction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that the holy name would be heard in every town and every village.
我们应该努力达成主宰当年马哈布鲁的预言，让主的圣名传遍每一个城镇和乡村。
And so you take up this mission, and you get the way.
你承担这个使命，便会得到祝福。
就是您刚刚讲到，在那个小组的讨论之中，给别人的这个建议，就是希望别人能够成为一个全职的奉献者。但是如果有新人也像你像我们这样询问的时候，我们应该怎样给出一个恰当的建议呢？是不是也告诉他们成为一个全职的奉献者，或者说兼职的奉献者，是怎样给出比较好？
Guru Maharaj, in your yesterday afternoon's group exercise, you told them that this young man should become a full-time devotee, but if there is some new devotee asking us the same kind of question, how can we guide them? How can we suggest to them? We should say the same thing to them?
Yes.
是的，我们要给他们同样的建议。
Actually, yesterday in the class, one of the students,who was a sannyasi.
其实昨天上课的一个同学是一位 sannyasi.
And before he became a devotee, he used to be a doctor.
他在成为奉献者之前，他就是医生。
And he gave up being a doctor to become a devotee.
他放弃了做医生，成为奉献者。
And so he thought this exercise was very funny.
所以他觉得这个练习非常的有意思。
Because he'd already given up being a doctor to become a devotee.
因为他已经放弃了当医生，成了一个奉献者。
So even someone's new, they're a new man, but they have a desire to become Krishna conscious.
但即使一个人是个新人，但是他有愿望想要变得具有 Krishna 知觉。
We should encourage them.
我们应该鼓励他们。
Of course, we're not going to give them a danda. We're not going to make them a sannyasi.
当然了，我们不会马上给他一个单的，立刻让他成为萨尼亚西。
But we got to train him up, give him a chance to become a devotee.
但是我们可以给他一个机会去训练他，让他成为一位奉献者。
And what does he lose even if he's not successful? Is there any loss?
但他会失去什么呢？即使他不成功，他会有什么损失吗？
That even a person gives up his duties and is not successful, but there's no loss.
如果一个人放弃了自己的职责，他没有去恰当的履行自己的职责，但是对于他而言没有任何的损失。
But what does he gain if he goes in the material world?
但是如果他去物质世界之内的话，他能够获得什么呢？
What does the man gain if he loses his eternal soul?
如果他失去了自己永恒的灵魂，这个人能够得到什么呢？
He goes into material life, he becomes a doctor and a surgeon or whatever, you know. What did he gain from that life?
进入物质生活之中，成为一个医生，成为一个外科手术的这个手术师，然后他从这种生活之中能够获得什么呢？
But if he does a little devotional service.If he takes up devotional service, even though he may not maintain it for long, but if he tries, there's no loss.
但如果他接受了奉献服务，即使他不能够一直坚持下去的话，对于他来说呢，也没有任何的损失。
The greatest benefits is there.
有最大的好处在其中。Guru Maharaj, I was thinking the devotees are afraid to give such suggestions because.If in the future this man become regretted, then they would complain to devotees, and that the whole family would also complain to devotees. Oh, 我的意思，我问的问题说，奉献者一般的很犹豫给人这样的建议，是因为就害怕他以后后悔了怎么办，他就会埋怨你，然后他们全家人都会埋怨你，所以一般奉献者就。
Yeah. Material world people always complain. Whatever you do, they'll complain. You never satisfy the family member.
永远也不能让他的家里人满意。
Doesn't matter what you do.
无论你做什么。
They say, "Oh, I'm going to the doctor. Will they be satisfied?" No.
说他就满足了吗？不。
You cannot satisfy people in the material world.
你无法去满足物质世界的人。
There was a young woman there. She said, "Well." What if he needs to get married?
有一年轻的女士，她就问说：“那她需要结婚怎么办？”
Well, if he's going to get married, well, you should marry a devoted woman, right?
你要结婚，你也找一个奉献者结婚，找个奉献者的女子结婚。
Find a woman who is not materialistic.
找一个不那么物质主义的女人结婚。
Who can live simply?
她可以过简朴的生活。
Will be satisfied with simple living.
他对他对简朴的生活、崇高的思想会满足。找这样一个人结婚
，not very easy.
不容易。
讲课呀，写书啊，派出。我的问题是，乞讨了以后，这个服务的结果不一定是万事如意，就是随我们的。有些结果不是我们想要的，虽然我们乞讨了，但也这个结果也不一定想要的。是不是意味着我们虽然现先前参加乞讨，我们也不要太依附结果，因为不是所有的结果乞讨了就会有，是不是这样？中文叫万事如意，岁岁平安。我祈祷，祈祷完以后必须实现我的愿望，但不是祈祷了后就所有的愿望都能实现。
We pray for everything going on very well with us, but maybe we get an unexpected result.
If our desire is not
fulfilled, then how should we do? How we deal with the situation? It's not that everything goes on very well.
Yeah, we have to be tolerant.
我们必须要容忍。
We have to understand this material world. We will not get perfection here.
我们要明白到这是物质世界，在这里是得不到完美的。
But we keep endeavoring.
但是我们一直不断的去努力。
开通难，万事开通难。
Everything is difficult in the beginning.
Right.So there will be problems. Yeah, things will not. We won't always get the things that they want to come out the way we want. You have to expect that.
一定会有困难的，不是所有的事情都是万事随心的，应该要意料到这一点。
There's going to be problems. There's going to be obstacles. You're going to give up?
会有问题，会有这些障碍，你会放弃吗
？When going gets tough, then the tough get going.
如果你要是遇到艰难的情况，就是迎难而上。
We have to expect things will be difficult.
我们应该预料到情况会变得很困难。
But we should be willing to keep going.
但是我们应该愿意继续下去。
And depend on Krishna.
我们应该依靠 Krishna.
Did Prabhupada have it easy?
巴帕的他就容易了吗？
No, there are so many difficulties.
有这么多的困难。
His whole life there were difficulties.
他的一生之中都充满了艰难。
When he went to America, it was more difficult.
当他去美国的时候更困难了。
But didn't give up.
但他没有放弃。
Just keep going, depend on Krishna.
他一直不断的一直去依靠 Krishna.
So don't be attached to the results.
所以不要依附结果。
Be attached to the endeavor.
依附于努力。
说的我们要鼓励别人去做一个全职的奉献者，然后我们经常在课里就说我们要履行我们的父定之责。